The students to get more support has created technical guidance, just as for a blind person, he used to be carried by somebody else, just as a person who is stuttering carries a walking stick, such as a person who is insufficiently visioned, he uses spectacles. Technology has come for the intellectually handicapped emerging student community of multimedia in the form of various software and hardware systems by means of which the people they are developing. Now, this is the study of various things. And concluding this with various other development possibilities which are existing in various fields. Number one, we have to understand two major phenomena behind the development or the futuristic fortune of multimedia industry. One is linear modulation, second is video compression. If there is no linearity possibility and if there is no video compression possibility, this industry would not have grown. And still now the linearity is in problems. Of if it is developed, digital signal processors, they can be made more, because whenever you are having linear modulation, technically, we want to understand that there are two things. One is the phase structure. Second is the amplitude structure. The amplitude and phase structures of each and every signal process that can be coded and transmitted effectively so that different types of signals or different types of informations can be received in a single database or in a single handset. A single handset can have multi-nodular as well as multi-modular receptivity because of the linearity holding the probability of dealing with this type of modulation of linearity as well as this graphical video compression made easily possible. Now you know that we are having advanced system like MPEG-4 now for video compression. This type of advancement whereby more video database are compressed, more signals are processed with more swift, with more security, with more clarity. This is by the compression technology and modular technology. A lot of people are doing research on that. If it is processed, if it is made successful with more modulation, certainly each and every domestic operation will be easily handled. Your domestic operation, all domestic operation, like what we are having in the form of a taxation, we are forming the electrical services of the society, civil supply services, farming, marketing, innumerable things, whatever we are having now. If we are having a multi-modular and multi-nodular accessibility with this compression and linear modulation development, we can have an e-society. Just as we are having e-governance, we are having an e-society possibility wherein by each and everybody will have their own burden less. So there are three opportunities. One, if you get a profit, that is also a profit. Second thing, if you don't get loss, that is also a profit. Third thing, if you get your work, even though not directly profit, if you get your workload lessened, if you get your tension lessened, if you can handle things easily, that is also a profit which makes you to get more solace, peace and comfort so that you can dedicate further things. This multimedia industry not only giving profit for industries, apart from that, lessening the loss of mismanagement, lessening the loss of loss, lessening the possibilities of maldiversions and various other ills that are there in governance, it can be having a digital invigilation. And the third thing, if you are capable of governing, everybody is quarreling for their domestic issues, they can maintain a very big company, but they cannot handle the milk issues, water issues and vegetable issues of the family. Even a very great, super efficient data management person, he cannot manage the data of his dhoti and other commodities given to a dhobi and something connected with his cloths, milk and grocery. It is not possible. So a person can efficiently domestic governance, relative governance, harmony governance can be made by these people, by which he can maintain his stamina and stability more in his official proficiency, number one. And number two, now we are having innumerable systems of communication and mutual contact by means of poly-level or multi-level conferencing through teleconferencing or web conferencing. Now you know that this ICE core, it has developed now, CABLINK. The open source advanced web conferencing facility known as CABLINK can be developed. But the problem is, each and everybody, without using the shooting system, boosting system, booting system and operative system, it is known without even Linux. Linux is also not an open source software. We call it as open source. That which does not require any other system to be incorporated, that which is script and designing you can make, it is known as open source, where you are completely independent and sovereign in that nature. Even we can create our own web conferencing, we can make our own domestic, interrelative, our own fraternal, associative benefits to be done, we can do all of these things. Multimedia is a cottage industry. But due to this domination and monopoly of people like Microsoft and various other people. It has been made as a very highly infrastructural, ultraviolet, superior industry, which is giving different glamour, color and favor in the society, which is making those people rich and we ever dependent on them. So second thing is real open source. If there are some people, some handful of 10 or 20 people, I discussed with Bhatkar also, 10 or 20 people who can create their own operating systems, number one. Number two, they can create their own limited operating system for their own thing. Maybe they can independently exist. There are few people who have designed that. There is a doctorate person who has designed, who has made 10 standard fail people to design their own system by which they can script and design things without CAD, without CAD, without C++. Without all of these tools, they have made these people to think. What I want to say is, whatever you have been given the source tools, your mind is more powerful than that, number one. Number two, your mind and brain is more powerful that you can design a thing which for which you are dependent on somebody who has already designed it. These two things are the powerful motto which has to drive each and every innovative person, that you are more powerful to be independently existing. Number two, even if you want to dependent, you can create your own dependent tool. You are having such much of creativity. So web conferencing is the second thing. Third thing is, you might have read about metadata. Now, advanced data processing and data management system is known as metadata systems. And we are having also, now recently they have developed, but they have not been made successful. One, I want to say, in spite of developments, most of the things were not being successful because of two reasons. One is the socio-economical setup. Second is the political setup. As we have been branded as dependents of international, multinational associates, we are having some Western or Euromaniac, some sort of system which is affecting our indigenous development. We are suffering a lot. What I want to say here is very simple. Interactive digital television network has been developed. Video phone that has been developed and video text has been developed before two decades. Why they have not been made successful? Not because of their cost. You see, now at the time of recession, 60 jewelry shops with the estimate of 750 crores have been established in 2 months only in Tamil Nadu. Where is recession? With what? If there is really recession, if there is really unaffordability, why they are starting new things? You are seeing advertisements of various things. Have you seen any advertisements reduced in quality or quantity in your televisions? Lot of consumers, lot of consumer-driven attractive things, crazy things, unwanted things, pernicious things, everything is advertised in TVs. So, the society has not been properly taught and trained in use of advanced mechanisms. Video text failed. Video phone they installed, it failed. And likewise, digital interactive television network is very useful for education and for mutual conversation. That also has successfully failed because of non-adaptability. So, because whenever you are developing anything in a society, you must not only understand the technology, you must also understand the mind setup, the socio-economical and political factors of the land, so that it can be effectively implanted. That is not there in the society. And education and this thing, multimedia, is very much essential for study. Richard Mayer, he has made a very detailed study and research methodology of using advanced multimedia tools for education. He has published a book. Somebody should go through that. And 70% of the future multimedia will be there in education and knowledge management. More than, now entertainment is more in advertisements and I think entertainment is more rather than this type of knowledge management and education. So education is going to be more because there are more universities and e-campus, e-learning, e-selection, EduSat, teleconferencing, interactive digital network, then distant learning, online administration, everything is going